Crystal Wade here with Let's Wade In. So glad you could join us today. Do you know that you have something very special? You have access to a world-class coach. Many people all over the world have great gifts, gifts of running, gifts of swimming, other kind of gifts, but they don't have access to a world-class coach. It's very difficult to be in competitions that proves that you're the champion if you don't have a world-class coach, but you do. And this coach wants you to become the champion that he created you to be, and it is your Heavenly Father. And when you have a coach, when you have a world-class coach, you've got to figure out, what do they want? I may have a gift, but I'm here to learn, and so what does this world-class coach want? Your Heavenly Father, who is your world-class coach, wants something from you. And do you know what he wants? He wants first a relationship with you. What a relief that is. What a relief. Other coaches push. They push for the development. Develop this, work harder on this, do that. A lot of different things we have to do to please them and develop our gift. Well, we do need to please our Heavenly Father and develop our gift, but that's not the first thing. The first thing that He wants is a relationship with you. And the good news is He is easier to please than people. I know that may sound odd. The Heavenly Father, God of all creation, is easier to please than people? Yes. Yes, He is. And let me tell you why. He is easier to please than people because He doesn't change. People change. They change their likes, what they want. They're always changing. And because He doesn't get tired or hungry. A lot of us, all of us, get tired and hungry at different points in our life, and that changes how pleasable or not pleasable we are, not Him. He doesn't get tired or hungry. He doesn't change, and He loves you. And that is why He is easier to please than people. So how do I develop a relationship with this world-class coach that wants me, that wants you, son and daughter, to be the champion that you are? Well, the first way is this. Spend time with Him. Now, how do you spend time with your Heavenly Father that you don't see? Now, some of you may have the gift of seeing, and you may see a lot of things in the spiritual realm, and you may have seen Him or may not. And if you haven't, how do you please someone you can't see? How do you spend time? Well, the first way is you read what He left for you to know about Him. And it's the Word of God, Scripture, also called the Bible. So read it and spend time with Him and His Holy Spirit. Now, His Holy Spirit is with you at all times. So you don't have to just read this book like you would read a science book and have to memorize all this stuff. You don't have to do this. You're reading, and then you're asking the Holy Spirit, who's right there with you, Holy Spirit, what do you want me to know? And He will take from the Word, and He will cause things to pop out at you. And so when something pops out or gets your attention, just stop and think about it. The Holy Spirit is speaking with you at that point, and that spending time is helping you develop a relationship with your world-class coach, who is your Father. Another way is to watch Let's Wade In videos. You can learn a lot about your Heavenly Father and the race of your own life through Let's Wade In videos. And another way is to tell your Heavenly Father what you think or feel. Now, when I was growing up, it was emphasized in our church circles that the Heavenly Father knows everything. He knows everything. So I thought to myself, what is the point of saying something to the Heavenly Father that He already knows? What's the point? He already knows it. But you know what? He has taught me through the years, and I'm sharing this with you because you're a champion and you are building your relationship with your world-class coach, is this. Tell him what you are thinking and what you are feeling, because you are the most important in all of creation. And he wants to know about you. And as much as he is doing in time and space and eternity and heaven and earth and all these things, he will stop the world to listen to you. And do you know what that does? It builds your relationship. So just stop and tell him what you think and feel about different things. And then you stop and ask him, what does he think and feel about different things? And you will be surprised at what you will hear. It will be good. Sometimes it's right then, and sometimes it's you get up and you go out and you're outside and suddenly you hear or understand something, and it was a Heavenly Father answering your question. And that builds your relationship with your world-class coach as you are going with God and going for the gold in the race of your own life.